Having Parkinson's kind of crept up on me. I didn't really know what these disparate symptoms were until it kind of reached a critical mass. The first thing I noticed was a slight tremor, so of course I went to the internet and said, looked up tremor, and they said, everybody has tremors. And then I started getting this pain in my shoulder, and then I went to my primary care and I said, you know, Mitch, I think I have Parkinson's. He says, he tested me. He says, nah, you don't have Parkinson's, no. I said, I do. It's a sneaky little devil, you know, it kind of creeps up on you. Where it's most challenging for me is when I rest my hands, I tremor. When my hands are engaged, like this, if I were to, you know, bend this, my hands stay firm. And you can see now that my hands aren't engaged, I'm tremoring. It's interesting because it does make you feel aged. You see people nimbly writing, you know, their signatures or a letter or a note or a reminder, and I can't, my handwriting has just gone to hell in a handbasket. I'm a creative person, so I thought, well, how do you handle, this is a challenge, so you can go boo-hoo, which I've had occasional moments, but it's okay. How can you be creative about it? How do you adjust, or how do I adjust my condition to the reality and deal with it? My Parkinson's is a good cover because people don't realize the sharp mind and the intellect that's behind the mask of the face or what I'm capable of. And I do feel very fortunate to still have the creative spirit, although people have asked me what's the hardest thing about, you know, your life as an artist? And I would not say Parkinson's. I would say my biggest fear is where my next idea is going to come from.